Hello and welcome to this latest in a series of videos that we're producing on the subject of trunking. We have the great pleasure of having lecturer Jake with us again.
Thank you.
Thank you for joining us, mate. What are we actually going to be covering in this video, Jake?
So in a previous video, we've looked at putting more common accessories together. We looked at the flat 90s and the internal and external. In this video, we're going to look at the more complicated ones, offsets and reducers as well.
Fantastic. So what we're going to do is we're going to bring the camera in nice and close and we're going to have a look at some of these accessories that we want to connect together.
So we'll take a look at a T now, Joe, but this time we're going to look at the different size trunking, 100mm by 50mm. It's a different size, but it's exactly the same slots together, just as the 50 by 50 did. There we go. I can screw that together now.
Very good. So it's nice to see this slightly different size of trunking. So again, if you're working at a college or you learnt in a college, then normally 50 by 50 is sort of the standard that we always work with. So it's nice to see just something a little bit different. It's all the same principles, just a slightly larger size.
If I can get my screws in, Joe.
This is reality. Sometimes screws get dropped. One of the best pieces of advice that anyone ever gave me about working on sites is when you drop a screw on the floor, it always bounces in the opposite direction to what you think. And that is a guiding principle that I've lived my life
about
by.
Usually bounces about a mile away as well.
Absolutely. Yeah. So those horizontal sections connected up, and again it couldn't be simpler, could it?
That's right, and just the vertical part now to fix together.
Yep. So that just slides in nice and easy. Very good. And again we're seeing the benefit of this type of trunking. So this is the fast fix trunking from Atcor, and we're really seeing the benefit of that raised lip there on the inside of the accessory, because it very simply just gives you a point to push the trunking up to, and you know that you're always going to be somewhere in the right position, which is good. Happy days. Look at that. Fast fix indeed. So again, we'll snap some lid on as an example. And it's just worth seeing there, Jake, over on that side, you've got a different number of screws to what you'd have on the 50 by 50.
That's right, yeah, that just had one on this size of trunk and we've got two screws.
Very good. Could we just have a look at the other side of that lid, if that'll come off
yep.
Nice and easy? So again, it's the same accessories, isn't it? The same turnbuckles
there. That's right,
there.
Yeah.
You've just got one at the top and one at the bottom. So that's really good. Nice to see that. And while we were talking off camera, you fitted that piece, which was brilliant, like a ninja.
And then we'll snap the T-lid into place.
Very good. So again, we've just left this upright piece off as a demonstration. And you can see there that just goes on really nice and easily. Now, what's interesting is this is all pretty much exactly the same as we've seen already, but the accessories that we're going to be looking at next have a slightly different fixing method for both the trunking and the lid, but we'll get to that in a moment. So where would we sort of see this being used, Jake?
So a bit similar to when we looked at the flat 90 in a previous video, really, where we need to change direction. So we're running along a wall, we need to drop down.
Ah, nice.
But also in this case, we want to continue the trunking further as well.
Very good. So if we're dropping down to some accessories or a consumer unit or something like that, then that would be brilliant. And of course, we can also use it the other way. We can come down with a single piece of trunking and then we can use that to lead to a horizontal piece
yep.
at a lower level. Fantastic. Really good. Okay, so that's great. We'll move on to our next accessory.
So we'll take a look at an offset now, Joe, using the 50 by 50 trunking.
Very nice. Okay, so an offset. So what's the principle here? What does this do for us?
Yep, so if we're running trunking along a wall, like so, and we need to overcome an object, we can use an offset to get round that and then another one to set back to the wall again.
Very nice. So it's anywhere there's a change in level of the wall or a change in perhaps height in a ceiling.
That's right, yep.
Good stuff.
So a little bit different to the other ones. It doesn't just slide in. We've got to use a coupler for these ones.
Okay.
So the coupler will go between both.
Very nice. And this particular accessory, again, from Atcor, that comes with the coupler inside the offset accessory there, doesn't it?
That's right, yeah.
Very good. Excellent. So you don't have to worry about ordering separate couplers for these. They come in a wanna.
So we've just got four screws per side now.
Very nice. Very good. And of course, again, we've got the benefit of the pre-drilled hole in the accessory and then the hope for the best hole that we've drilled. Very good. Excellent. Yeah, so it's interesting. So there's, again, these two different types of fixing method that at core have used here. And this is the use of the coupler, so there's those extra screws. But again, this is actually how most manufacturers produce their trunking, with the need for a coupler for these things. So actually the fact that Atcor have got those accessories that don't need a coupler and that have that snap-on lid really does show the benefit of that range. That's good, so that's that side popped on already. And again, we can see inside there, we've got that coupler hiding away, just sliding out ready to get into view. Excellent.
Just slide that over the coupler, same as
very nice.
Last time, making sure both all them holes meet up.
Very good. Excellent. So again, it all comes down to how accurate your drilling is. And I think we've mentioned a couple of times that we've used the idea of a template from Eddie from Pegasus Electrical, who demonstrated that to us, and we're showing it to you now. So thank you, or we did in a previous video, I should say. So we thank Eddie for doing that, because that saved us a lot of time in the making of this series of videos, which has been brilliant. We can be sure it'll save you time as well. So if you're not sure what we're talking about, please do go and check out the video where we describe that template that you can use for your trunking. Very good. Very nice. So there we go, that is the coupler attached. And then when we draw back and look at that, again, you can start to appreciate what we're looking at there. You can see that change in height that it facilitates for the trunking there, which is really good. Anything just to think about that's slightly different with the lid here, Joe?
Yeah, so we'll put the lid on. So I'll just put the lid on the trunking first.
Very good.
So as we said, mentioned earlier, it's not quite the same as the other pieces we've used, so it doesn't just snap on. This time we've got the turnbuckles on the lid as well.
Very good.
Make sure we get that lid the right way around.
That's critical, yeah, very important. Good stuff. Excellent, and that's just a sort of a quarter turn for those turnbuckles, yeah?
Okay.
Very nice, and that holds that in place. Now, I can't help but notice, Jake, despite your excellent craftsmanship here, there is a little gap between those
there
two
is,
lids
yeah.
there. So is there any kind of accessory we can put on there to help us with that situation?
There is, yeah. We've got some joint covers that just snap on over there to maintain the IP rating of IP4X.
Good stuff. Let's just cut to that footage now.
So as you said, Joe, even though I've cut this piece of lid expertly, we still have a slight gap with it being a different type of lid, not being the snap-on type.
Very good. I like that modesty doesn't prevent you from saying you did that expertly, so that's good. So show us how this works then, Joe.
So, yeah. Obviously, top of an enclosure, IP rating must be IP4X minimum, so these joint covers help us to keep that.
Very nice.
Snaps on, nice and simple.
And that really does, again, however expertly you've cut that lid, you're never going to get that gap absolutely perfect. So yep. That also just helps to hide any kind of unsightly gap between the lids there. Really good, like that. Okay then, Jake, so once again, we've got laid out on the bench here what looks like one of those exploded diagrams from a Swedish flat pack furniture retailer. So what's going on here?
Yeah, so we've got a reducer, Joe, or perhaps an enlarger.
Just depends on your mindset,
it
doesn't
does,
it?
Yeah.
Absolutely.
So this, same as the last one we've looked at, you need your couplers for this one. It doesn't just slot together. So
oh, okay, right. So we've got that situation
we have the
again.
Coupler between.
Yeah, and again, looking at the lid over on the right there, I can see the telltale heads of the turnbuckles there, which means that we've got the slightly different method of fixing.
That's right, so I'll just line that up again, get these screws in this side first.
Very nice. Again, Jake's taking a brave pill because we're not using pre-drilled manufacturer holes on our trunking. So he's very confident in himself being able to drill those accurately, and I think he's been validated in that belief through the course of this series of videos. Done a good job. Look how perfectly that one's lining up as well. Look at that. Absolutely beautiful. There we go. So that's this side done. Now, over on the other side, Jake, that little coupler you put in, that's not going to fit over there. So what's
not,
the solution
so
on this side?
We've got the larger coupler this side to fit the 100x50 trunking.
Excellent. So you've got a coupler the same size as the trunking that's going to bridge that gap for us and bring
that's
those
right,
two pieces
yeah.
of trunking together. Very good.
There we go.
Right, so once again, we've got that neatly lined up. And it's just a matter of popping those screws in and joining those together. Now, so far in this series of videos, we haven't discussed the subject of earth straps and we haven't installed any. So we're deeply curious to know what your thoughts are on that. So as you're watching this video and you're thinking about trunking, feel free to comment on the use of earth straps. Necessary, unnecessary? Do you need them sometimes and not other times? Please let us know what your thoughts are in the comments section below. Nice. So that's all of those screws done up, nice and tight. And those separate pieces of trunking have now become one continuous system. And again, where would we think about using this, Jake? Where would we need to use a reducer like this?
So it might be as we're coming into a distribution board, something like that.
Yep. So it may be that perhaps we've already branched off further on the left there, where you've got the larger trunking. Lots of cables have already disappeared out of here. And economically speaking, there's no point continuing that 50 by 100 trunking any further because you've got less cables going through here, maybe.
Yeah, that's right.
Makes perfect sense.
So I'll pop the lid on the trunking first.
And again, we're just resting the lid on in this case just to demonstrate how this goes together. And then we put the faceplate on for the reducer.
So again, it's a lid with the turnbuckles in. It's very not nice. A snap-on lid.
Very good.
Turn those now, get this lid on.
So just those 90 degree turns. And again, sometimes you wrestle with these, don't you? They can be a little bit tricky sometimes to get in place. And in this case, they're snapping on really nice and easily. And there you go, as we draw back, you can see how that all fits together to leave you with a nice, neat, compact enclosure there, which is absolutely brilliant. So there's our three accessories for this video. Thanks very much, Joe. So there we go. Those are the three accessories that we wanted to take a quick look at in this video. So just remind us what they were, Jake.
Yeah, so we looked at tees, reducers and offsets too.
Happy days.
And I'm not talking about the American rapper offset from the group Migos. That's a different type of offset.
That's good because my mind was definitely going down that road. Thank you for once again highlighting the vast difference in our ages there, Jake. Much appreciated. So if you'd like to comment on anything that we've looked at in this video, if you think that we've missed a trick somewhere, if there's another type of device or accessory that you think you'd like to feature in this series of videos, or even if you have strong opinions on the oeuvre of Migos.
Migos, yeah.
Migos, then also please feel free to comment on that below. I suspect we're not going to get many of them, Jake. Okay. But as always, we want to hear from you. So please leave all of those questions and thoughts in the comments section below, and Jake promises faithfully that he's going to get back to every single one of those, so make the questions as hard as you possibly can. And as always, all that remains in this video is to say
thank you very much for watching.
Again, that is my line.